It's a good right here.
Baby. Baby. Come on. Hiya. Hiya. Come on. Yeah, get your ass out of there. This is Hotel Indigo, where they had concierge and valet parking that we didn't know about. And I feel bad because he couldn't tip. There was a $75 pet cleaning fee. Interesting view. I think she likes it. Dubby's free. We're at Fort Stockton, halfway to my parents' house from El Paso. I haven't been filming, but we've just been driving. We stayed the night in Tucson, Arizona, which was really cool. I want to go there just for kicks and giggles on our own time sometime. Because, like, they have an old town and it's, like, really old western kind of stuff there to check out. And then we stayed at El Paso, like, literally, like, behind our hotel, like, a walk away. You could walk. Like, the border to Mexico. I kept looking at my Google map like, wow. So right behind us is Mexico. Wow. But yes, we're on our way to my parents. We got 4.5 hours left for Kwismasss. Kwismasss. Happy Chrysler. Oh, there's a Walmart. Oh, Dad told me about the Walmart at Fort Stockton. I'm gonna make the jump. Did he give up? Oh, he's looking at the chicken. I wonder if he would like it. Hey, Dasher. Here. Dasher.
I like this hairy top.
Oh, it's great.
It's like a rubber band. It didn't work.
Ow! You cooked me. Okay. Ow. Skin. Sam's like, what is this thing? Maybe I'll fling it for him again.
He's stupid. Asher, you dummy.
Who wants to play a game?
Thank you.
Yeah. Who's ready to play a game? Raise your hand. You ready to play a game?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm just filming for memory's sake.
Right.
check out this matryoshka. Jewish matryoshka.
Here's a hard one.
Lisa got a fish. She's a vegetarian. Daniel's watching his weight. No, he's doing the Mickey Mouse challenge. The Christmas Carol Mickey Mouse challenge. You know how they like cut the pea in half to disperse?
No, this is just, I finished most of it. A big serving.
Can we stop? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, dig in, Nanny. Dig in.
Everyone make sure you kiss the cook.
Yes, when you finish, Rebecca, make a plate of toast for
Bella. Yes, ma'am.
Ooh. There we go. I was actually looking for cool.
You want this one? It hasn't popped?
Sure. That's like a pinch. There's no way.
Daniel's the daredevil. I'm going to film evidence of him losing his finger, so he'll always remember.
Do you have a finger?
Right?
The Christmas Daniel
lost his
finger.
You're going to have to use your skin.
The other two, not so much.
No.
Give
it
to you,
I would soon
find out. Trust me.
I can't even.
You use your teeth.
You could sit maybe even if you just hold it.
You would pull you it. If I bit down, you don't want it.
She's just not.
Rebecca? Peter will do it. Yeah, Peter isn't scared to have his fingers explode. He plays Russian roulette all the time.
Sorry, what are your words of wisdom?
So, what type of room has no windows or doors?
A box.
Has no windows or
cellar,
doors.
A dungeon.
A type of room. What type of room has no windows or doors? Room.
A room for people that have mental illness?
A mushroom.
That's a good one. Mushroom. What is that?
What kind of room is it? Okay,
I'm for that. Magnet.
And nobody watches those videos of lights.
Is it gonna go on the roof?
This is the hair ball.
Who's fur? All of them?
All of them.
Your collection of cat fur.
Mm-hmm.
That's so big though. That's a lot of fur. Hello, Becca here in my otaku brother's bedroom of what is, dreams.
What does that mean?
Otaku is like an anime kind of nerd in Japan. An otaku. We're walking like old times, like Georgia times. Me and Dana used to go on walks. Sorry that I look like a bum. I thought I looked like royalty, but now that I'm looking at myself, it's clear that I look like I would dig in your trash.
No, Rebecca, you look like everything.
A puppy! Japanese tea garden.
Yeah.
Y'all just got here though, right? You went up the stairs?
Yeah, it took a while. Well, we found a ramp for her to go up.
Oh, good. Okay.
Yeah.
You've been here before, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I'm gonna go find you. Is it where they are?
Go through that center thing and you'll see them. They're looking out. Really busy today. Usually it's like hardly anyone here, but I guess because it's the holidays, everyone's visiting for Christmas and we're like, oh, let's go to the gardens. Oh yeah, one of them's having a sit down. Maybe it has a nest or something. Oh, Dad woke him up. Oh no, I can feel his feet, his foot claws digging. Watching Avatar.
Me, Abby's watching.
Ariana's watching.
If you want a daily dose of exclusive content, movie reviews, and fresh takes.
Da 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 da. Hi. Hi there. Hi. She was so pissed off at Lisa's house because the girls, she went like a limp. She actually wanted to go in her backpack. That's what she gets. That's what she gets for being a bratty catty. Can't believe it's pretty much over winter break. It's crazy how time just flies by like that. Christmas was done in a flash. We went, we came to DFW at like 3 a.m. So that, from San Antonio, because Peter is volunteering at the Dickies Arena for a passion conference. So, from San Antonio to DFW, it's like 4.5 to 5 hour drive. So we had to get up at 3 a.m. So he's probably like, zombified. He's gonna be even more zombified by the end of the conference. But yeah, well, I dropped him off at the arena. And I went to Lisa's house to see the girls and Lisa. And we dropped Bella off there to stretch a bit, and we went to see Avatar, and we cried. Well, I cried. I say we, but like, I don't think anyone else cried, but all of us were deeply saddened by the events. It's an emotional roller coaster. Isaac's checked into this hotel. He's attending Passion with his friend. He's on the second floor. I actually had to go down and show my ID card because he's not 21 yet, and they said he couldn't check in unless he was 21 or older. So, good thing we are staying at the same hotel. So that worked out. They should be on their way to the arena now. It's Isaac's second passion. His first one was at the Benz in Atlanta. And this one, yeah. Close. Texas. And it's a lot warmer than Georgia, too. So I think it got up to, like, the 70s today, even though it was windy. So that's what they're doing, and I'm just chilling here. I might order Hawaiian Bros, but I don't know, because I have a small appetite, and I can't eat a full thing of food. But there's no microwave in this hotel room, so if I got it, I won't be able to warm it up. cold pork. I don't mind eating cold pork. I do mind eating cold rice, though, I think. I don't know. Like, for me, I grew up eating, like, cold chicken and turkey and whatnot. It's maybe a British thing to eat meat, cooked meat, cold. I don't know, but they have some really good Kahlua pork, that pulled pork, Hawaiian pulled pork. Heaven.
Yoo-hoo.
Oh, yeah.
Look, it's you.
Oh. Where are you going?
Meow, meow. Oh, what a cutie. Yeah, are you so happy? Yeah.
Look who's getting used to car life. She stopped exploring the car, now she's just lounging. Is it comfy? Yeah. It's the last day of Passion Conference. I'm in the car with the cat waiting. Peter Isaac and his friend are in the Dickies Arena. That. Afterward, we're gonna head to Bucky's. We're going to Bucky's. Gonna get some snacks for the road. Yeah, snacks. And then head to Amarillo. Me and Peter, we're headed back to Nevada. Cutie cat. Well, thank you for not biting me. I can never tell if she's gonna lick me or bite me. Susanna's just got back from up north in the snow. She was up in
Michigan.
A lot of snow. And Isaac, he's heading back to San Antonio. And we're headed back to Nevada. Okay, here we are with our good friend Bucky. When you go to Texas, you must go to Bucky's. It's a must. We arrived to Amarillo. Me and Peter's bed, Bella's bed. Do you like your bed? Do you like your bed? Yeah. Look at this wind. It's so bad. It feels like we'll be lifted. It feels like the car is being lifted. Like when I'm driving, it's like I'm fighting against a wind, and it's like 70. Oh, he were okay, good. He was filling his tank. That's crazy out here. Like, look at this guy, he's suffering. And poor Peter is about to fill the tank. No, it really feels like we're being lifted, and like. When the wind hit really hard, it felt like it was gonna lift the car off the road. I guess he forgot his receipt to ask for the receipt. Or maybe he's astonished by the gas price. Because we're getting further west. this poor man. No, poor Peter.
Give me her own email. Greta's email address is I have small dick energy. Come get your own email. You also don't have a super tender. It's good.
No snow. We were hoping for snow. Well, the slushy rain stuff is coming down. When we went to the car to park, it was submerged in a giant puddle, so Peter's feet are soaked. His shoes are soaked through. Peter's shoes got soaked through from the puddle, which sucks because it's a 4-hour drive home. So we decided no Grand Canyon this time. I was wondering if we should do the Grand Canyon because there's a winter storm warning. So maybe that was it. That was like God being like, you don't want to be stuck at the Grand Canyon, do you? Get Peter's toes a little wet. I did want to see the peaks of the Grand Canyon covered in snow, though. That would have been so pretty. Oh well. We got Bella, too, so I'd feel bad. Like, well, we wouldn't stay for too long. It's like an hour and a half drive there from Flagstaff. Oh. We're driving through a winter wonderland. Carefully. Very carefully. Wow. To put her back in because she kept trying to get over to Peter's side. I don't think we're gonna see snow. This winter storm is pulling through, but I think we're just gonna get rain most of the way home. It's a bear. Those freak me out so much because like we went to this gas station and I walked past it and he started talking like asking if I wanted to try my fortune or something. I don't know. He's freaking looking at me. The Indian fortune teller. There's like a little bear. Oh, there we go. Ain't he cute? Ain't he a looker? Hey there, little bear. Hey there.
Something was off. There's no reason she would have done that. She was worried about being all alone in the cabin, and she knew it was going to be right at that moment. So, feeling panicked, Dr. Burke